Projects are unique, and their successful completion requires that hundreds or thousands of interdependent tasks are carried out in a specific sequence. Information about conditions affecting the progress of these tasks that is available for the project team is, however, always incomplete. In other words, all projects have to be carried out under the condition of uncertainty. For example, a team constructing a house has no way of knowing for certain whether heavy storms will prevent the progress of work 3 months from now or not. It can also not be known beforehand if some of the project team members are going to fall ill or injure themselves during the project. Unwanted surprises during the project might be related to external actors as well. Perhaps one of the subcontractors selected for the project will suddenly run out of money and withdraw its crew from the project site. While project teams tend to focus their attention towards unfavorable surprises, it is important to be aware that not all events which may occur threaten the progress of the project. For example, during project implementation, the customer may suddenly decide to order additional functionality to the project, allowing the supplier to increase its profit margin. Generally, events threatening the project are referred to as risks, while events favorable for the project are referred to as opportunities. In large projects, the question is not whether such events will take place, but to which extent and how they will influence the project, and how the project team has prepared for their potential occurrence using risk management practices. An understanding of the nature of project risk is the cornerstone of successfully managing them. Risks can be placed into four distinct categories. First, pure risks typically arise suddenly but have a very low probability of occurrence. Examples of pure risks include, for example, fires and earthquakes. When these kinds of events occur, they tend to have very severe consequences towards the project. Second, financial risks relate to the availability of flow and money in the project. These include, for example, changes in currency rates, which may significantly affect the profitability of international projects. A further example of a financial risk is that the customer, for a reason or another, is not paying its invoices on time, which negatively affects project cash flow and potentially also the ability of the supplier to pay the bills of its own subcontractors. Third, area-specific risks relate to a geographical area, such as a country or a region within a specific country. For example, in some regions of the world, corruption or even a sudden armed crisis may severely threaten the progress of the project and the safety of the individuals working for it. In addition to societal challenges, environmental conditions may also pose challenges to projects. For example, some areas are prone to heavy rains that may last for weeks and require that most project operations are suspended for the duration. Business risks, the final category, includes all risks that do not fit to the earlier mentioned categories, but threaten the completion of the project or the intended use of its deliverable. Thus, this category may include a very diverse array of risks, such as: will the project deliverable perform as promised when operated by the customer? Will the motivation and morale of the project team remain high throughout the project? Will external actors, such as local political groups, continue to support the project through its entire life cycle? Do chosen subcontractors perform as expected during the project? Any risk can be characterized by two factors: the probability of its occurrence and the cost of its impact on the project. For example, the risk of a severe earthquake is likely to have a very low probability of occurrence, but a very high cost impact on the project. On the other hand, ground conditions in a house building project are very likely to affect the project to some extent, as the ground can be harder than expected, perhaps creating the need to use explosives, or more muddy than expected, increasing the need to use support structures. On the more positive side, ground conditions may also turn out to be better than expected, favorably contributing to project costs, as less time than expected is required for groundworks. As such, this case of ground conditions can be considered as both a risk as well as an opportunity. By multiplying the probability of a risk with its expected impact, we can determine its magnitude, which relates closely to the mathematical concept of expected value. Assessing the magnitude of risks allows the project team to focus their attention towards the risks that matter the most. Risks with a low probability of occurrence and a low impact are typically considered insignificant, whereas risks with both a high probability and high impact are paid most attention by the project team. Project risk management consists of four interdependent activities. The aim of the first activity is to identify risks, a task that is often highly challenging as no two projects are alike. The second activity, risk evaluation, focuses on developing a thorough understanding on the nature of the identified risks and, if they realize, how they may contribute to the progress and costs of the project. The third activity is concerned with developing and deploying concrete actions through which the project team actively influences risks. For example, by reducing the probability of their occurrence or the expected impact. Finally, the fourth activity is concerned with ensuring that the techniques and tools used in risk management are appropriate and that risk management is carried out throughout the entire life cycle of the project. In the following, we will explore these four activities in more detail.